Finally, let's have a look at deploying Flowise to our very own cloud service. This option can be cheaper than the official Flowise cloud service, and in the documentation, you can see all sorts of articles for deploying Flowise to AWS, Azure, and many other service providers. I've personally used Render for my Flowise instances, and these instances have been running for nearly 2 years without any issues. So for this tutorial, I will also recommend going with Render. So first, go over to render.com and create your free account. Then from your dashboard, click on Add New, then Add a Web Service. And from this page, you will be asked to connect to your GitHub repository. So go over to github.com and sign up for a free account. Then in the description of this video, you will find a link to the Flowise repository on GitHub. Open up this page, then click on Fork, leave everything on the default values, and click on Create Fork. This will create a copy of the Flowise repository in your very own namespace. So back in Render, you should see an option to connect your GitHub repo, so go ahead and do that, and in the list of repositories, select FlowiseAI, then click on Connect, then give your web service a name, and because I already have an instance of Flowise deployed, I'll just call this one FlowiseAI Tutorial. Then scrolling down, we can leave the language as Docker, leave the branch as main, and then under the instance type, with a free plan, your flows won't be persisted and you will lose all of your work when the server is restarted. So it might be perfect for following along with this tutorial, but I definitely recommend upgrading to the starter package if you do want to continue working with Flowise. But for now, we'll simply start with the $7 per month package. Scrolling down, we can also add environment variables. For the first variable, let's create a variable called Flowise_username. And let's set our username value. I'll simply call mine admin. Let's add another variable for the Flowise password. And I'll simply enter the password as password123. I would suggest that you use something way more secure than this. Let's add a few more variables. Let's set the port as 3000. Let's add another variable for the node version, which we can set as 18.18.1. Now the following variables are not needed if you are using the free plan, but if you do want persistent storage, in other words, you don't want to lose your flows whenever the server is restarted, we can go ahead and add the following variables. Let's set the API key path as /opt/render/.flowise. Let's add another variable for the database path, and this is the exact same value as the API key path. So I'll simply copy this value as we will be using it a few more times. Let's add another variable for the log path, which will also set equal to this value, but we'll also add /logs. Let's add one more variable, and this is the secret path with the value of opt render.flowise. I know that was tedious, but we are nearly done. All we need to do now is to attach the drive or the volume. Let's go to advanced, then under disk, let's click on add disk. And for the mount path, we'll paste in that same value that we used earlier. And for the disk size, I'll simply go with 1 gig. And believe it or not, but we are done. Let's simply click on deploy web service. The deployment will take a few minutes to complete. And we're now live. Great, so all we have to do to access Flowise is to click on this URL, and we will be prompted for a username and password, which we set as admin and password123, and we can now access Flowise. So do take note that if you self-host Flowise, the responsibility to keep Flowise up to date falls with you. But thankfully, that's super easy. Flowise is constantly adding new updates and fixes to their main GitHub repo. This text is currently saying that this branch is up to date, but if you are behind, it will say something in the lines of, this branch is behind a certain amount of commits. All you have to do in that example is to click on Sync Fork, and there will be a button here that will allow you to update your fork. In fact, let me show you an example from another repo, like this N8N fork that I have. So this N8N instance is sitting within my own namespace. And here we can see that this is actually 28 commits behind the main n8n repo. So when I go to sync fork, I can simply click on update branch. So now it's saying that this branch is up to date with the n8n master branch. And if I go back to my render dashboard, we can see that my n8n instance is now being redeployed with those new changes. For the remainder of this tutorial, I will be using a local instance of Flowise. There is a bonus section towards the end of the course where we'll integrate Flowise with Telegram, and for that we will need a cloud instance of Flowise, but for everything else we will be using the local instance of Flowise. But of course you can follow along using the cloud instance as well.